हेलो एंड वेलकम टू योर SST क्लास अगेन स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी, गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट रियली अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक, अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ आवर लाइफ. इट्स नॉट रेदर जस्ट एन टॉपिक टू स्टडी फॉर द सब्जेक्ट, बट इट्स अ हार्ड कोर रियलिटी ऑफ अ लाइफ, वन ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ अ लाइफ ऑफ एवरी पर्सन हु आर लिविंग इन द सोसाइटी. इफ समथिंग हैपन्स रॉन्ग विद समवन, देन अ पर्सन एक्सपेक्ट्स अ हायर अथॉरिटी टू गिव सम फेयर डिसीजन फॉर दैट रॉन्ग हैपन टू हिम और हर. देन अ पर्सन अप्रोचेस टू समबडी हु कैन प्रोवाइड अ फेयर डिसीजन. इन अर्लियर डेज पीपल यूज टू गो टू किंग्स एंड क्वींस फॉर दिस पर्पज. एज द टाइम एडवांस्ड द थिंग्स बिकेम मॉडर्न. दीज थिंग्स स्टार्टेड टर्निंग इन टू अ इंस्टीट्यूशन दैट वॉज कॉल्ड एज कोर्ट्स. यस माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव हर्ड द राइट वर्ड, कोर्ट. कोर्ट आर द प्लेसेस, दे आर द ऑफन ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज टेम्पल ऑफ जस्टिस, वे पीपल सीक, वे पीपल वेंट टू एक्सपेक्ट अ फेयर डिसीजन, टू हियर अ फेयर डिसीजन. ओके, सो बिफोर गेटिंग इन टू दिस जस्टिस, जुडिशरी, ऑल दिस टर्म्स, लेट मी कोट यू फ्यू लाइन्स अबाउट अ वेरी फेमस प्रोमिनेंट लीडर, रूजवेल्ट, वॉट ही हैज सेड अबाउट द वर्ड जस्टिस, सो दैट वी विल बी हैविंग अ मोर डेप्थ दैट हाउ इम्पोर्टेंट दिस वर्ड इज, वाई दिस वर्ड इज सो मच इम्पोर्टेंट इन अवर लाइफ. सो लेट मी रीड आउट फ्यू लाइन्स अबाउट जस्टिस कोटेड बाई रूजवेल्ट. रूजवेल्ट सेज, जस्टिस कंसिस्ट ऑफ नॉट इन बींग न्यूट्रल बिटवीन राइट एंड रॉन्ग, बट इन फाइंडिंग आउट द राइट एंड अपहोल्डिंग इट वेन एवर फाउंड अगेंस्ट द वर्ल्ड. मीन्स रूजवेल्ट सेज कि जस्टिस इज नॉट ओनली अ मैटर ऑफ फाइंडिंग हु इज राइट एंड हु इज रॉन्ग, इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ बीइंग, टेकिंग अ स्टैंड ऑफ वॉट इज राइट. इफ यू फील दैट समथिंग इज राइट, वी शुड टेक अ स्टैंड फॉर इट. वी शुड फाइट फॉर द फॉल्स स्टेटमेंट्स, वी शुड फाइट फॉर द बैड थिंग्स. ओके, वी शुड फाइट फॉर द रॉन्ग थिंग्स. दैट इज ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ जस्टिस. इट इज नॉट ओनली अबाउट यू नो अनाउंसिंग अ जजमेंट, बट मेकिंग अ स्टैंड, क्लिकिंग टू द ट्रूथ, होल्डिंग टू द ट्रूथ, नॉट लिविंग द पार्ट ऑफ ट्रूथ इज ऑल्सो अ जस्टिस. सो लेट स्टार्ट विद द टर्म्स. वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड स्लोली एंड स्टेडली दैट वॉट दिस एंटायर प्रोसेस इज. टू एनफोर्स द रूल ऑफ लॉ, वी हैव अ जुडिशियल सिस्टम दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ मैकेनिज्म दैट आर कॉल्ड एज कोर्ट. वी हैव अ डेफिनेट सेट ऑफ लॉज इन द कंट्री दैट आर कॉल्ड, समटाइम्स कॉल्ड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, समटाइम दे आर जस्ट रेफर्ड एज अ सिंपल वर्ड लॉ. ओके, सो इफ एनी वेयर वी फाउंड दैट अ रूल इज बींग चैलेंज, अ लॉ इज बींग ब्रोकन, देन पीपल मूव टू इंस्टीट्यूशन दैट इज कॉल्ड एज कोर्ट्स. सिटीजन कैन अप्रोच व्हेन अ लॉ इज वायलेटेड, ऑफकोर्स, बिकॉज द लॉ इज इक्वल फॉर एवरीबडी. इफ वी स्पीक अबाउट अवर कंट्री इंडिया, हियर देर इज अ क्लियर कट रूल दैट इन फ्रंट ऑफ लॉ एवरीबडी इज इक्वल. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सो मच इंस्टेंसेज, सो मच केसेस वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर अंडरस्टैंडिंग द लॉज. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन सो मच ऑफ डिटेल, सो वील नॉट गो बैक टू दैट थिंग अगेन. लॉज आर इक्वल फॉर ऑल. सर्टेन प्रोसीजर्स आर टू बी फॉलोड वेन लॉ इज बींग वायलेटेड. वेन ए पर्सन ब्रीचेज अ लॉ, वेन ए पर्सन वायलेट्स अ लॉ, देन द सर्टेन देर इज अ सर्टेन सेट्स ऑफ रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस दैट आर टू बी फॉलोड विद दैट सो कॉल्ड कल्प्रिट. ओके, जुडिशरी, दिस एंटायर सिस्टम why does this judiciary deals with all this mechanism? Why does judiciary go for this giving decisions, giving punishments to the culprit, giving justice to the victim? Why it is so? Because judiciary wants smooth functioning of the country, and if the judiciary will be strong, no doubt the democracy of the country will also be strong. If a common man is being awarded justice, then of course each and every citizen of the country who has given his vote to elect the government, that person will be safe and satisfied. Okay, judiciary can only work best if it is independent. Yes, this is one more crucial point. Judiciary can work only and only in that case if it is independent. There should be no interference of whatsoever any outside body on judiciary. Okay, like government is having three wings, as we have discussed in class 7th also when we were trying to learn democracy. A democratic country is having three main pillars. India is having three main pillars to run the government, that is judiciary, executive and legislative. So judiciary is independent from those two wings. Okay, role of judiciary one of the main role of judiciary is to deal with different types of disputes, cases, whether they are small or big. If the cases are of small nature, lenient nature, the crime is not so much offensive, it is being taken by session courts or the lower courts. If the issue is too big, it's of national interest, yeah, state level interest, it is being taken care by state courts, high courts or Supreme Court. Okay, so let's see what all ahead is there in this chapter to be discussed in this particular video explanation. Be connected with the video so that you can. Okay, students, let's continue the chapter ahead. We were discussing some reasons what is the role of judiciary. Fine. So one of the major role of judiciary is resolving the disputes, the resolution of disputes. Disputes can be of any nature, from common to a serious nature, from a local city level to a national security issue. They can be of any depth and height. Citizen versus government issue. If a particular citizen is not satisfied, yeah, he is anywhere having any sort of grievances, anywhere he has been, something wrong has went with him by the government machinery, then he can file a case against the government. Cases in state government versus state government, as we have seen in the previous chapter, the Cauvery Water case, when two states were having different issues regarding the share of the water of river Cauvery. That was example of case state versus state. In central versus state, when a central government has some different ideology regarding the functioning of the law and order. Like, I just give you a small example. It's not exactly the same, but somewhat correlating. In J&K, couple of years earlier, there was Article 370 implemented. So many of the rules were not applied in J&K state. It was having its different set of constitution. Okay, so if anything unpleasant happens over there, the different rules were applied for that particular state. So in some condition, the things are straight away face to face different for state and center. Fine. Okay, now the next power of the court is of doing the judicial review. Dear students, as we have already discussed, let me revive once again. The judiciary, the executive, the legislature. Judiciary we are already discussing the current topic. The main work of legislature, as far as the legislature is concerned, the main work of constructing the laws, making the law, of which judiciary take care, is being done by the parliament. Parliament is the body in our country which makes the law. Okay, but if at any point of time the court feels that the law made by the parliament
is not beneficial for the mass, for the public, then they can revoke that law. They can revise that law. They can revise that law. They can ask the parliament to take it back, or they can make amendments in that. Okay. If they find any law which is being made by the parliament, it is harming the basic structure of Indian constitution, then also they can ask the parliament to uphold that law. That law can't be taken into implementation. Fine. Also, next point is upholding the law and enforcing the fundamental rights. This is a small example. As you all know, the time which we are having nearby our surroundings, it's an pandemic time of deadly virus, coronavirus. See, you might have seen whenever we hear that a particular locality has been sealed down, okay, yeah, lockdown is implemented in more strict way in a particular colony where some cases are being found, even though that entire locality is being locked down from all the ways. It is being sealed. People are not allowed to come out from that colony. Nobody is allowed to enter into that colony. Okay. Those people are asked to stay strictly in their home. But the basic things of their life, like water facility, providing water facility. Okay. Cleanliness facility. Foods, vegetable, edible items. Okay. Electricity. Okay. Other basic facilities of life. Those who are in that particular area, they can't be debarred from that basic amenities, because those basic amenities are a part of life. Water is a part of life. Security is a part of life. Those people also have a right to leave. So we can't stop their food supply facility. We can't stop their water supply facility, because their basic right, the basic right of every citizen of a country is right to life. Okay, this is a basic fundamental right. We can't deprive anybody from right to live. So you might have seen, even though an area is properly, is strictly sealed, still those people will be provided with the basic life saving facilities. Okay, so this was the thing which I was trying to explain, that upholding the law and enforcing the fundamental rights. If court feels that a law is getting too much strict, okay, then the court can announce, they can give a decision to that, so that law can be upheld and fundamental rights can be ensured. Fundamental right is the most basic thing in our country. Nothing is above the fundamental rights. If in any case fundamental rights are being harmed or violated, then even the laws are being kept aside in order to ensure the proper implementation of fundamental rights. We'll discuss further in this video. Let's see what ahead is there. Okay, now we are into the last topic of today's video. Last topic. What is an independent judiciary? How can we claim that a judiciary is independent? Why is it so? First of all, the powers of the people running the country, they are all separated. Okay? If suppose there's a person who is representing the area, member of parliament, a member of legislative assembly, MP or MLA, or any police officer, they are having separate work to do. They can't interfere in any of the work of judiciary. As far as judiciary is concerned, their powers are separated, their works are separated. Fine. So they will be working parallelly for the betterment of the country without interfering in the tasks of judiciary. Okay. As I have already discussed in the same video, executive and legislature, one of the two main pillars of democracy, are also not allowed to interfere in any task of judicial system of the judicial courts. They don't have permission to interfere in the work of judiciary. They are nobody to put a question mark and to ask the judges about their any way they are announcing a judgment, so that unbiased decision can be made and judges can announce a decision without any pressure, okay, without any political executive interference. As far as the appointment of judges are concerned, the appointment of judges are also kept away from the political interference, from the political parties interference. They are being directly elected. The judges of High Court and Supreme Court are being elected by the President of India. And their removal also is a very typical process. That is also being taken care by under the head of President of India. So neither the government have any function in appointing the judges, right? Neither the government officials have any role in removing the judges. So with that way, judges find themselves more safe, more prominent, more respectful job, more responsible job, and they are able to do their work freely. So my dear students, that's all in this particular particular part of video. We will be upbringing the further topics in our next video. So for today, for this particular video, that's it. That we'll be discussing the chapter up to here only. Fine. Hope you might have understood the essence of judiciary. We will be continuing this chapter ahead in our upcoming videos. Thank you and have a nice day.